like to say that we know we need more women in leadership. And in essence, I think that means we need more troublemakers. And so we'd love to hear more about that with all of you today. Crystal, can you tell us who's with you here today?
Absolutely. So I have Jeressa Bryant, Jeressa Sullivan.
I know, we're recording.
Yes, oh my goodness. But I knew her when she was Jeressa Bryant, and now I know her as Jeressa Sullivan. Jeressa and I have had this amazing mentoring relationship for 14 years now, and I'm so proud. She's now the executive director at MAC. So, lighten it up. Then I've got Riana Frazier here. Riana's been with me for about 4 years now, and she is a territory manager for OPI, one of my favorite brands on the planet. Now I have little April here, who is an amazing stylist. She's one of our lead stylists. She just premiered at Fashion Week, Brandon Maxwell for us. These are some of my amazing mentees. Having a mentor really changed my life because, you know, having a woman, that understood the struggles, could meet me where I was and really coach me through what it was like to be the only one at the table. And, you know, it's something that they actually have all heard me talk about, Ramsey Burns, my mentor, because she changed my life. And really without her guidance and her support and her tough love, I wouldn't be here. I would literally still be doing work for other people. So that's really, you know, one piece of the mentorship is like why it's so important for women. But then the other piece is, as we're talking about women from other cultures, you know, we're not necessarily raised. Like for me, coming from a traditional Asian household, you're not raised to speak up. You're not raised to rock the boat. Certainly not raised to make trouble, right? And then, you know, as it is February's Black History Month and just this whole concept of representation, I think it's even more important. And I started thinking about, you know, just some of these relationships and the privilege I have working with them, but also kind of common themes. And so I was like, well, I think it's a really relevant topic to say, you know, for BIPOC women, how do you build these relationships? How do you support them so that they can be this next generation of representation, so then more women will dream and be like, I can be like her. So these are just a few, but super near. They all think they're the favorite.
Yeah.
Open with that. They all think they're the favorite.
It really is so special to be with all of you, and I appreciate you taking the time to share some of your mentorship stories, because that is such an important ingredient, as mm-hmm. Crystal said. So why don't we start out with you sharing how the mentorship started, and in particular, actually talk a little bit about how it stuck, how it stayed, because I think that's part of the secret of success. So who wants to start? All right.
I'm a stylist in a very luxury high-end salon. Me going into that space was me taking a risk just in itself and just saying, this is what I want to do and this is what I will do. However, being in that space, I found myself falling into a comfort zone of this is enough. Okay, I'm here now. I'm in the, you know, one of the top salons in New York City. Okay, this is where I am. But then, you know, I know that I have other dreams and other ambitions, and Crystal noticed that. And she noticed the things that I was doing outside of the salon to kind of, you know, excel and propel myself forward. And we had a conversation. We had a conversation. She asked me what my goals were, and I just straight up asked her. I was like, okay, Crystal, I know you're the COO of, you know, Frederick Fekai. However, can you be my mentor? And I wanted that because I needed guidance. I needed guidance to help me get outside of that box that I was stuck in. And like I said, I didn't have any examples of what to do. My example, coming to New York City and the path that was laid out for me, came from a book called The Fashion and Style Guide. And she listed out for hairstylists, makeup artists, nail techs, different ways on how you can make it through the industry. Mm-hmm. And so my background is military. I was in the military before I decided to move to New York. And so me doing the reading, one of the top salons that she said to go to, you know, to be the best salon, best stylist in the industry was Frederick Fekai. And so my mindset was set on going to Frederick Fekai. And so once I got there, I was like, okay, so what's next? You know, I don't want to be stuck in the salon just doing hair behind the chair every single day. I'm a creative and those things get stale. So Crystal, you know, she provides accountability, a lot of accountability. She provides tough love, but these are the things that I need to get myself out of the comfort zone. But also, like I stated before, I'm a creative, and so sometimes I tend to be all over the place. So she also provides focus as well. She provides focus, she provides encouragement, and also just giving me words that allows me to believe in myself a little bit more, you know? So yeah, I am grateful for Crystal, and she I don't know if I've ever told her the things that she's, you know, done for me, just from the conversations, just from the accountability. Like that, it really puts me on another path. And since we've started working together, my career has excelled so much more. You know, she thinks about me in those places where other people don't or may not think about me. The salon is a male-dominated, you know, environment. And not saying that that's a bad thing, that's just the way that it is. To have someone that's at a higher level that thinks about me and thinks that, okay, this I have her who can, she can do this, you know, she can represent our company, she can represent our brand, and I believe in her. And so I thank you for that, Crystal. I appreciate you.
Well, I appreciate you so
yes.
much.
That's so beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm with all around the world. I feel that I don't like I have so much to say, you know, about that, but I mean, it is very, very special. I never had anyone to just take me under the wing. I've always had to figure it out for myself. And I'm from Alabama, you know, and Alabama to New York City is totally different environment.
Yes.
You know, and so I thought I was doing good just to make it here and to be in the top salon, but she's like, what? Like, you can absolutely do way more than that. And so, I mean, I'm seeing it. I'm seeing it, and I'm grateful. I'm grateful for her.
I love that. The accountability, focus, and confidence.
Yes.
That's a
And helping
pretty,
you lay out a path so you're not all over the place.
It's
beautiful.
Because
you just
you
start
said
trying
it's beautiful.
Things.
Yes. It's beautiful.
Yes.
So sweet. I, too, am grateful for my Crystal Wood.
Yes.
I met her at a time that there was someone that wasn't being so nice to my Crystal. And she was just, like, always showered everyone with love and smiles whenever she's in your space. So this one particular person, I just had it that day. I said, you know what? I have to tell her. I was a single mom at that time. I didn't know Crystal in that way that she could have gone back. She could have gotten upset and gone back to that person and said something. But I was able to trust her. I found trust in her. And she appreciated that. And from there, our relationship blossomed. It blossomed on that trust. That I was able to introduce her to my family, my son, and she welcomed him in with open arms. She calls him her grandson. But all of that has cultivated me into the person I am. And she, just like you, she made me believe in myself.
Yes.
She's given me that tough love to feel like I can do anything. And I remember asking her, like, how can I pay you back? Like, what can I do? She said, no, just pay it forward. So in every single thing that I do and every success that I've made in my career, I know I'm paying it forward. And I mentor as well because I know people are looking at me.
Yeah.
So I owe that to my Crystal and helping me find my voice and find my space to be where I am.
Yeah, that's beautiful. And your bravery and courage to take that leap of faith that you said is, those moments can go either way. So, and think about the course of
your trajectory now here.
Exactly.
And I mean, in our relationship grew, it went both ways. So she's learned more about me. I've learned more about her. I'm able to watch her growth and
that's
she's able to see my growth. We're learning from each other. And we can share with other people.
That's right.
And the point on paying it forward and how much more impact that comes about and the benefits that that spread from all of you is incredible. So I love that part of your story too.
Thank you.
Yeah. I would just say the joy and the energy right now is just so amazing because I feel like all of our stories are very close and relatable. And even just sitting at this table, it's all like the spirit energy is just there, like all this positive energy. Yes. And thank you to Crystal because when I met her, I used to work for her. And when I first met Crystal, she walked into the room and owned it. And, you know, as someone going through their career, you look for women that, you know, that inspire you. And when I first met her, she walked into the room and she was, like, on top of herself. She knew her business. She knew, speaking very clearly, very confident. And I was like, that's what I want to be. Like, those are my goals to get to. And through that, when we met, you know, our relationship just blossomed. I think our spirits just connected. And what I love so much about her is she's asking the right questions to make you think.
That's right.
She makes you dig deeper to kind of pull out that magic that's deep inside of you. She sees it, and you know you have it, but it takes someone to ask those questions, to encourage you, and then get you a seat at the table. Because sometimes you don't even get the opportunity to get to the table or let your voice be heard. Mm-hmm. So it's just amazing to have people like Crystal to be able to give you those opportunities, but also advocate for you and continue to spread the word where other people start paying attention.
Mm-hmm.
and bring people together. So through our mentorship, I've learned so much about giving back. I've learned so much about speaking up, having a voice. I've learned so much about doing the right thing, like what's right. When you're making decisions, personal or business, think about what's right and putting people first. And doing those things, you can never go wrong, right? It blossoms. And so, and following her lead, here we are today. So even through our mentorship, I decided to go back to school and get my MBA.
Awesome.
I'm graduating in May.
You are?
Yes. Awesome. Thank you. Fabulous. And through that process, Crystal's first person I called to talk about the process and what I should look forward to and just everything that goes along with it. And so here I am 2 years later about to graduate. So thank you for that. Yes.
The advocacy piece of what you all talked about, knowing it, but then the self-doubt moments that I think all of us have, and then having somebody there to overcome those for us and believe in us. I mean, I'm hearing that thread across all of your stories. It's incredible. And as you said, I know you're doing that for other people around you. So think of, I mean, the power of the impact of one to three to the folks that you touch, that's remarkable.
That's right. And you know, for other girls, other women of color that wants to be in one of the positions, now we're in that space to where we can serve as an example for them. You know, it's not a blind path anymore. Like, you can see it and it's believable. I think one of the things that makes us kind of self-doubt ourselves in those certain situations is because there's no example of us there.
Absolutely.
So it's like, am I in the right place? Or I know I'm in the right place, but what am I going to do to excel, you know, to kind of stand up to everyone else that's there and that's doing it?
Yeah. And to piggyback off what you said, I recently hired someone, and when I interviewed her, I was like, this is it. Because it was like her story, just seeing how she was stagnant in a position for so long. She was super smart. I saw myself in her. Mm-hmm. So I was so happy that I was able to meet her, and I pour into her so much that now I was able to get her promoted. Like, her confidence, she's being seen within the organization. Like, I'm so happy.
Yeah. And those moments, I mean, those moments either come and someone like you guys jumps in and it happens, or they pass and then you're waiting, and it's so those moments that matter are incredible, and to be able to have them and give them, get them and give them, that's an incredible,
special
place to be in.
And I think you're changing lives. Like, I feel like even like a lot of women that I connect with, they may want to go down a new career path, or they may need additional resources, support, and they just don't know. And so just having simple conversations, or, hey, look into this, or look into that, you never know, just
speaking up their name in a room, you're changing people's lives one step at a time.
Mm-hmm. So what advice would you give to someone who's looking for a mentor? Because you guys obviously all hit the lottery, and you've shared that, and you appreciate that and recognize that. And, you know, that's worth a lot, because a lot of people wouldn't. But if you were going to give advice to someone else about how to look for a mentor, what you would look for in a mentor, what kind of advice would you give?
I would say step outside of your comfort zone. Sometimes we tend to be in a space and our heads down. We're not talking to anyone. We're not going out networking. We're not doing any of that. And so if you want a mentor, you have to talk. You have to speak. You have to talk to others that's around you. You know, identify someone who's doing what you're doing and have conversations with them. And who know, they may even offer to be your mentor. You probably won't even have to ask. I really didn't have to ask Crystal, honestly. It was after the conversation, like you can tell, like that relationship was already there. So I would just say identify someone that you respect and have some of the qualities and attributes that you want to have, and then go from there.
The same. I didn't ask Crystal. Crystal told me she was my mentor. I welcomed it. But the advice that I would give is that you need to, when you set your goals, I'm a goal person. I set goals daily, long term. When you look at your goals and you align to where you want to be, find that person in that space that's above you that you can learn from. And you build that relationship that way. You have to be hungry for that knowledge.
Yes.
You want to have to continue to learn at all times. And I'm proud to say, Crystal is my mentor and my sponsor. Mm-hmm. Like, she speaks, she will say my name when I'm not around, and I know that. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm a reflection of that. She's blushing. Yeah. But it's very true. Like, you find, I'm lucky to say that she's my sponsor and my mentor.
Yeah.
But it's important to understand both.
Yeah.
So I have that. I have my Crystal, and I love her.
No, I totally agree with both points said. And I think also, when you look for a mentor, I think that both mentee and mentor have to do the work for each other, right?
Yes.
And so I kind of found that when you know you have the mentor that inspires you, or you're the one reaching out, you're the one, let's do coffee, let's do lunch, and vice versa, you're receiving. So giving and receiving is not a one-way path. So that's the one thing that I do when you're looking for a mentor. I think that should be a key thing to consider about the communication and making sure it's just not coming from one side.
And also know, being a mentee is not an easy job. Like, you still have things that, like we said, she's holding us accountable to things. And if we want to get to the level that we say we want to get to, you have to put in the work. You have to do the work.
Yes.
And if you don't, you're going to get tough love.
Exactly.
I don't want to have this conversation.
Yes.
I'm like, okay. And you don't.
But the point you guys are making about out of your comfort zone and being vulnerable and doing the work and being open to receiving those tough love messages, that is all on you. And and you got to have, as you said, it's not a one-way street. You've got somebody who's you're connecting with, and they're willing to take that risk too. That's magical.
Absolutely.
You guys clearly have the magical moments.
I want to add to that. There's no time limit of when you can get a mentor.
Right.
Like, I feel like maybe sometimes in a place in your life you may be stagnant or complacent, like I think I know, or, you know, maybe not motivated. So to add to the, you know, two-sided communication and relationship, I think you can get a mentor at any time.
This has been amazing, and what a joy to be able to spend the time with you all today. I really appreciate it. So Crystal and April and Riana and Jeressa, thank you for sharing your stories and your inspiration, because putting it out there is the best lesson for so many people. So we love to say you can't make history if you don't make trouble, and that's trouble for good, and you guys are badass.